turtles have been around for millions of years and remain largely unevolved, so they've obviously made themselves pretty good already. Turtle hatchlings are very independent, so they never meet their mother. They literally hatch out of the sand. They make their own way to the sea and they make their entire lives solo. Juvenile turtles, they never really come back to the reefs or shallows or anything like that. Mother turtles usually, they reach sexual maturity between 15 to 20 years of age. When a turtle comes to the beach, they find a suitable spot, they start to dig a burrow, which takes 1 or 2 hours. They usually dig their burrows with the two back flippers, so it's a very slow process, but they dig them very kind of narrow and very, very deep. The deeper the burrow is, the cooler the sand is. The temperature of the sand that the mother lays the eggs in actually determines the gender of the turtles themselves. The deeper part of the burrow, where the sand is generally a little bit cooler, they usually come out as males, and then the ones that are a bit warmer or an entire burrow that is dug a little bit shallower will come out as females, which is kind of slowly being affected by climate change, and then also the problem with people digging up the turtles to move them to a new hatchery or to dig up the turtles to hatch them artificially themselves. The turtle hatchlings all hatch at roughly the same time. There'll be a few stronger ones that are digging their way out of the nest, which make it a little bit easier for the rest of them. So they do it as a mass exodus altogether, because it obviously protects them from predators that they might find. Once they've got out of the burrow and they start walking down the beach, that's them actually rubbing an imprint on their tummy of the beach that they were born, so they know either exactly the beach to come back to or the area. A turtle, as soon as it's kind of hatched out of its egg, has got about 72 hours of energy left in the sac that is still attached to the turtle tummy. And they use that to dig their way out of a burrow, run all the way down the beach and swim as far out to sea as possible. They usually find a bit of flotsam, which is either an old tree's trunk. More increasingly these days, it's ghost fishing nets and things like that, anything that's floating on the surface of the water, and then they'll just live underneath it. So they've got a good shelter from any seabirds or anything that can actually see them. They're very, very easy prey because they've got quite a soft shell for the first 6 months of their life. And then they spend time either catching all the little fish that live under there as well, and jellyfish and little bits of plankton, training their lungs to expand and to be able to prolong their time underwater so they can actually free dive and hunt for food and rest and relax underwater. And this is why it's really important for the first few years of their life is to be deep out at sea. Around the world, there are a lot of turtle conservation groups that are hatching their own turtles or getting eggs from somewhere, hatching them themselves and keeping them in tanks. I feel that people that are running these aquariums and these turtle hatcheries with the title of turtle conservation really think that they have got the turtles' interests at heart, and that's why they're trying to do it. They think that because a baby turtle is so, so vulnerable when it's so small, they're actually protecting it and feeding it until it's strong enough to be released into the wild. In these first 6 months and the first year, turtles do need to spend this time free diving down. So actually being kept in a tank and not being able to forage for its own food means that its lungs aren't going to properly develop in its early stages, all the way through to the fact that they're getting fed at regular times. They are then, you know, waiting in very, very shallow waters, expecting to be fed by the hand of man. Turtles are largely solitary animals, apart from when they do want to breed. So keeping them in such close proximity does mean that they start to bite each other, they get aggravated. You find a lot of damage to either their carapace or to their flippers and things like that, which makes them prone to infection. And as soon as one baby turtle will get an infection in a tank, it just means that every turtle is going to be getting the same infection. It's usually more due to the lack of education and awareness and maybe scientific research in that area that it's actually kind of detrimental to the turtle's health. I sadly wouldn't put their survival rates at being very high. So it's really important that turtle hatchlings, in their first 72 hours of life, that they can get all the way down to the sea unaided, if possible, and make their own way. Turtle hatchlings really don't need help in getting to the sea. They've been doing it for millions of years on their own. When you get islands that maybe 20 years ago, they were largely uninhabited, not too many people, and especially no light or any noise pollution on the beach, then turtles are always going to come. but because they don't come back for the next 20 years, something might have changed. So a suitable beach for a turtle to nest in is very dark, it's very quiet. As soon as a turtle comes up onto a beach, if it hears the slightest bit of noise that it's nervous about, or it sees a light which it knows isn't the moon, it's going to turn straight back and maybe try again the next day. They are running out of places to actually walk up on the beach and be able to nest. Good turtle conservation is turning your lights off at night, making sure that there isn't too much noise pollution, so loud music gets kept to a minimum after dark, making sure there's no obstructions on the beach. So sunbeds, sun loungers, even bits of trash is enough to be able to restrict a turtle coming onto nest, or especially baby turtles coming back down. Even at your workplace, even when you're living in a city or nowhere near the sea, you can still actually help save turtles by reducing your plastic bag consumption. They generally find their way into the oceans and they look exactly like a jellyfish, especially to a turtle. One of the main sources in their diet is jellyfish, so they're found to ingest hundreds of plastic bags and plastic particles as well. There are ways that everybody can help turtles.